So stop me if you've heard this before.
You vegans are a bunch of turtles. All you do is eat greens. Turtle, turtle. Eat your lettuce.
And you know what? It might sound funny to you, but I'm not even mad because as a vegan, if you're doing things right, you would know that you should be eating a lot of whole foods, plant-based. And with that comes a lot of leafy greens like your lettuce, your spinach, your kale, which is my favorite as well. And we love a good pairing with a nice dressing. And so in today's video, I went ahead and followed my heart, and I'm going to go ahead and review some delicious dressings. You see right there? It literally says... whatever. Let's get going. So good to be seen, and it's even better to see you. What's going on? I hope you're doing well and staying safe. Thank you so much for stopping by. If we haven't met before, my name is Francis. I happen to be the CEO and founder of the Petmosphere app, as well as an animal rights activist and avid photographer. So if any of those topics interest you, then you've definitely come to the right place. So in today's video, I figured it would be a great idea to go ahead and review some dressings for you, specifically two from Follow Your Heart. This one's actually ranch. And the other one I have for you guys is Thousand Island, two of my very favorite dressings when I was actually not a vegan, because I liked that hearty, you know, creamy filling texture to my salad dressings. And lucky for us, we don't have to settle for the oil and vinegar and the balsamic vinaigrettes anymore. Some that actually kind of became really old to me, and I'll explain why. Before going vegan, you would know that most of the dressings that you and I probably liked contained a lot of dairy and egg, which are basically the foundation of the dressing itself. And so after going vegan, we had to sort of do away with that because we don't do that consumption anymore, right? And so we had to settle for the liquidy, runny kind of like reductions and the balsamic vinaigrettes, which, don't get me wrong, I did enjoy myself, but they got old kind of quick because they did not provide the kind of texture that I like as a dressing on my salads, first and foremost. And the second reason why they got old to me really fast is because they are so liquidy, they would tend to not stick to the actual salads and greens and leafy vegetables that we come to love, and they would scoot all the way to the bottom. So when I was done with my salad, I had literally like a puddle of balsamic vinaigrette. If that happened to you, let me know in the comments below, because it got old really quick. And so, like I mentioned earlier, we don't have to settle for those anymore because companies like Follow Your Heart have put together some decent lines of dressings, both of which we're going to be reviewing. Again, this is a ranch on my left hand, and I have Thousand Island on my right hand. Now, granted, these products were provided to me by my friends over at vmarketpr.com, who happened to be the sponsor of today's video. VMarketPR.com happens to be Puerto Rico's very own online marketplace for everything vegan, plant-based, and cruelty-free related. Anything you can think of, from whole foods plant-based to snacks that we've come to love, cleaning products, and everything in between, you can definitely find on vmarketpr.com. They feature excellent customer service, they have a chat available most of the day, and they also guarantee that if you order today, they will be knocking at your door with your items in less than 24 hours. So if you're in Puerto Rico like myself and you want to stay home while you do your online vegan shopping, then definitely swing by vmarketpr.com and tell them Francisco sent you. So thanks again to my friends over at vmarketpr.com for being the sponsor of today's episode. So in case you haven't seen any of my previous episodes before, the very first thing that I like to do when reviewing a product of this nature is to talk about the actual packaging, because it's literally the first thing that you see when you're walking down the aisle, or in this case, shopping online. So Follow Your Heart has actually provided us with a nice solid glass bottle. I love the label. I love the logo with the leafy sort of like heart looking apple kind of thing going on, which is pretty nice. The fact that the labels match is pretty easy to spot if you're actually a returning customer. So all you gotta do is just spot it and grab it, which is kind of neat. I have all the certifications here that you might expect from a vegan company, which is obviously dairy-free. egg-free, cholesterol, and preservative-free. So that's kind of neat to see on the label. It gives us the peace of mind that we are not, in fact, contributing to cruelty. One thing that did pop off to me in terms of the actual label is the fact that it was made with solar power. And that's kind of neat to know because whenever we can, as vegans, sponsor a company that has their products made efficiently and effectively, that's definitely a win-win in our book. So that's very cool to know. Another fun fact, this is actually made in California, and I can kind of tell because the label is all sunny and it has some palm trees in the background. So that's kind of neat. I like the label, 10 out of 10 on the label. So the second topic I always discuss in this video for your educational purposes, of course, is to discuss the nutrition facts label. As with every other episode, I think this is very important for those people who have some sort of allergy and don't want to, you know, necessarily go to the grocery store or hop online. This is why I do this favor for you. So without further ado, I'm going to read some nutrition facts here. I might actually do a little split screen here so that you can know the differences between these two flavors. Again, I have Thousand Island and ranch here. So let's start with the ranch. Ranch comes out to 130 calories per dressing. The bottle itself provides, according to this, 12 servings, and each serving size is approximately 2 tablespoons, which comes out to 30 grams. As far as total fat is concerned, you've got 18% of your daily value in here in every serving. Obviously, like I said before, no cholesterol whatsoever. Sodium is at 125 milligrams, providing your 5% of your daily value. Very low on carbs, 1 gram to be exact, which amounts to literally nothing of your daily value, which is great. No added sugars, no sugars whatsoever. And on the other hand, they have no protein in this whatsoever. Conversely, when it comes to the Thousand Island, it only has 80 calories per serving. The same serving is actually 2 tablespoons, which again is 30 grams. And obviously the size of the bottle is the same, and therefore you're gonna get the same amount of 12 servings. As opposed to the ranch, in this Thousand Island, you get 7 grams of total fat, which is 9% of your daily value. No trans fat, no saturated fat. Cholesterol is also, as you can expect, 0%. And this one's a little bit high in sodium, 200 milligrams amount to 9% of your daily value. Conversely, this one has a little bit of carbs, 4 grams, equaling a measly 1%. No fiber, unfortunately, but it does have 2 grams of added sugars to 4% of your DV. And again, no protein in this whatsoever. Vitamin D, calcium, potassium, and iron are negligible in contents. I think it's worth mentioning as well, I may have forgotten to say this earlier, but these are made with non-GMO ingredients. If you're not a fan of genetically modified foods, then you don't have to worry about that, making that decision when you're actually purchasing these products. And now the moment we have all been waiting for, and that is, of course, the taste and the texture. Now, admittedly, this is the second time around that I actually had purchased these. The very first time that meatmarketpr.com did provide these for me, I liked them so much that I went through them in a week and forgot to shoot this video. And I actually purchased these out of my own pocket to actually make this review. They're that good. Yes, they are that good. The ranch on one side is actually very creamy. It is reminiscent of the ranch that we are accustomed to enjoying previous to becoming vegan, of course. And the taste is actually mimicking the original ranch flavor that you're probably seeking to adopt as a vegan. So I definitely highly recommend that one. Whereas I want to say the Thousand Island is a little maybe sweeter and tangier, but just as creamy. And again, that's a reason why I chose to review these two for you, because they are in fact thicker and the heartier, and they're gonna stick to your veggies and your leafy greens a lot better than maybe like the aforementioned reduction and the balsamic vinaigrettes that we all know about, you know, whether it's like berry related or tahini or any other foundation that is also obviously plant-based. So the good friends over at Follow Your Heart actually provided a couple of recommendations here. It goes obviously great on salads. You should definitely try it on a sandwich and even on pizza as far as the ranch is concerned, whereas they recommend that you use the Thousand Island on like a burger sandwich also, as well as maybe what they call animal style fries, whatever the case may be. I don't even know what that is. If you do, let me know in the comments. And last but not least, you definitely want to know what you're going to invest in order to attain these products. And as it currently stands, vmarketpr.com is offering these for a little less than $6. I think one comes in at $5.39, the other comes in at $5.69, if I'm not mistaken. Don't quote me on that. Check the website. Prices obviously are subject to fluctuation, but for less than $6, you could actually get 12 ounces of these two delicious flavors, which I highly recommend. And I don't think I've ever done this on this channel before, but I'm gonna give these a 10 out of 10 because I have yet to find a more delicious dressing with which to accompany my leafy greens and my salads and even to dip. I would highly recommend these as a dip to, you know, baby carrots or celeries and things of that nature. So 10 out of 10, I highly recommend these products from Follow Your Heart. Will I be buying them again? Oh, absolutely. You can rest assured they will definitely be in my refrigerator perpetually. So that's it, guys. That's where I am going to leave it. If you have gotten a little bit of value out of watching this video and made a better purchasing decision out of these two dressings, go ahead and leave a like. Definitely helps the channel. And if you want to see more videos of vegan food reviews in the future, do your thing by subscribing. Make sure to hit the bell so that you don't miss a single one of my episodes. And before I forget, what would you like to see in a future episode? Let me know what item you've been marinating about purchasing, and maybe I could review that for you so that I could actually steer you in the right direction. Thank you so much for watching. My name is Francis, and I will see you guys in the next episode.